Welcome and thank you for joining us for this signed Christmas service. My name's Ricky and I'm one of the ministers at Rayleigh Baptist Church. If you're joining us for the first time, then a very warm welcome for you. Thank you for joining us and making time to connect with us this Christmas. If you are one of our regulars at our usual monthly signed services, then a welcome to you as well. Please know that we miss you and we can't wait to be back meeting with you again in person. But we're glad that you're able to join with us in this way this Christmas time. And we have produced this service especially for you. This is not us signing another service. This is a specific service put together for you, for the deaf community of Rayleigh Baptist Church and of Rayleigh and the surrounding area. So a very warm welcome to this service. We hope and pray that you will be blessed during our time together today. Let me pray as we begin. Father God, I thank you that we are able to join together in this way, even though it's not what we would choose, it's not the way that we would want to meet. Father, we know that it is so limited, but Lord, I thank you that by your Spirit you are able to meet with us today just as much in this service as if we were meeting together in person. Father, I pray by your Spirit that you would enable us to meet with you today, that we would be able to encounter you, that we would be able to sense your Spirit with us. Lord, I pray that you would enable us to worship in spirit and in truth today as we gather in this way. Lord, come and help prepare us for Christmas, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, we're going to sing a number of songs today. We're going to hear God's word and we're going to be looking at the story of the shepherds in particular. And then I'm going to bring a little reflection later as well. But let's start together by singing. And this is a fantastic song, While Shepherds Watch Their Flocks by Night. Let's sing together.
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, all seated on the ground, the angel of the Lord came down and glory shone around. Fear not, said he, for mighty dread had seized their troubled mind. Glad tidings of great joy I bring to you and all mankind. To you in David's town this day is born of David's line, a Savior who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be a sign.
Wonderful. I do hope you were singing and signing along with all of that. There'll be more songs a little bit later. Well, let me read a part of the Christmas story. It's from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20. And the story so far is that the Roman emperor has called a census, and so Joseph and a very pregnant Mary have to travel to Bethlehem to be counted. And whilst they're there, Mary gives birth to a baby boy. And scripture says that she wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. So let's read on, Luke chapter 2, verse 8 to 20. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign to you that you will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. What an amazing story. We're going to unpack that in a moment with a brief reflection. But first, let's sing again two fantastic Christmas songs, "O Holy Night," and then "Hark the Herald Angels Sing."
O holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Saviour's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices, O name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we. Let all within us praise his holy name. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices, O night of eye. When Christ was born, oh night divine, oh night, oh night divine. Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored. Christ the of peace, hail the Son of Righteousness, light and life to all he brings, brim with healing in his wings. Mild delay his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sun.
This part of the Christmas story, the story of the shepherds, is my personal favourite. It's a really simple story that we've all heard so many times, more times than I care to remember, and I'm sure it's the same for you. And it's the story of an unexpected invitation to unlikely people. And in many ways, the story is unremarkable. But let's dig just that little bit deeper and see what we notice. I wonder if you have ever felt excluded by people. Have you ever felt like you don't fit in somewhere? I guess that we all have at one time or another. But this is just how the shepherds will have felt. The wise men were outsiders, much like the shepherds, but the wise men were educated. They were pretty well off, and they had their own transport, as you'll see from all the camels on the Christmas cards. But the shepherds were almost the opposite, and yet heaven comes to them where they are. The shepherds were poor, uneducated, smelly and isolated. They were out in the fields when everybody else was at home. They were excluded and they were undervalued. They were the last people you would expect to be involved in the birth of Jesus, the Son of God. And yet, heaven comes to them where they are. They find themselves with a front row seat at all the action that was going on. They find themselves in the middle of this very unexpected scene. An angel comes from heaven and glory shines all around. There was a heavenly glow around them. And the shepherds were terrified. But the angel said, "Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, because I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people." The angel continued, "Today in Bethlehem, a saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah." The saviour, the Messiah, had been promised for a long time. Everyone was waiting for him. And now the shepherds have been told that he's been born. What an amazing night for the shepherds. What an amazing message. But it gets even more amazing, because not only does heaven meet them where they are, but the shepherds get an invitation to meet God. The message from the angel goes on and says, "You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. But only if you go looking. If you remain here in the field with your sheep, you won't find anything." Essentially, the question to the shepherds was, are you looking for God? Are you up for going on this journey and meeting with God? It's a question that we can ask ourselves. Are we up for meeting with God? You see, the shepherds weren't. They weren't looking for God that night. They were looking after their sheep. And then something happened to change that. The angel appeared with this incredible message. And the shepherds' response was amazing. They said, "Let's go and see for ourselves this thing the Lord has told us about." They probably didn't fully understand what Messiah even meant. Saviour might have been a little bit easier to grasp, one who saves. But they clearly sensed the importance of the message and they recognised it was from God. And so scripture continues in verse 16. "So they hurried off and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Leaving their flocks of sheep, risking losing their livelihood. But this was too important for them. They did not want to risk missing out. And so the shepherds went." Heaven met them where they were. And then there was an invitation for them to meet with God. And they went. They jumped at the chance. They took it. And then they have this amazing encounter with God. When they arrived, it says they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger, just as the angel had said. And that's it. That's it. They found Jesus in the manger, just as they said they would. The angel had said, "This will be a sign to you." Well, all newborn babies would be wrapped in cloths. That's not amazing. But only one would be lying in a manger. That's what was distinctive. That's how they knew this message was from God. That's how they knew that this was the child they were looking for. There was that one distinctive thing. Otherwise, the rest of the story is probably unremarkable. And yet, look what happens next in the story. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning all that they had been told about this child. Nothing about a baby in a manger proved that he was the Messiah, the Saviour. But the angel said that the baby in the manger would be the sign to them. And they went with their story. The angel with a ridiculous message, a massive choir praising God, and they believed the angel's message was true. The baby must be the long-promised Messiah, the Saviour. So the shepherds went telling their story of what they'd encountered, what they'd seen, what they'd heard. And everyone who heard their story was amazed. The shepherds were amazed at the angel with the message. And yes, the angelic choir of thousands. Absolutely, what an amazing encounter. The bit about the baby seems unremarkable, unless he is who the angel said he was, the Saviour. The angel knew. The shepherds had faith and believed, and they got to meet the Son of God that night. Heaven comes to the shepherds where they are. They receive an invitation to meet God. They respond positively and they go, and they have an unremarkable and yet powerful encounter with God. Note that when the shepherds returned to their fields and hopefully to their flocks, nothing had changed about their circumstances. They were still uneducated, they were still smelly, they were still materially poor, and they were still isolated. But now somehow they felt valued and they felt included. They felt like they had been chosen by God for this message. God chose the smelly, uneducated shepherds to be the first to meet his Son. And it started a pattern through Jesus' life and extends to today, bringing hope. Everything about this story gives me hope. If God is willing to meet the shepherds where they are, there is hope for you and for me. If God is willing to invite the shepherds to be involved in such an important event in history, then there is hope for you and for me. If God is willing to meet the shepherds in a glorious encounter, meeting his Son Jesus face to face, then there is hope of the same for you and for me. Whatever your frustrations, whatever your challenges, whatever your history, there is hope. The whole purpose of Jesus' life was to bring hope to everyone. And it all began that first Christmas when God joined the shepherds where they were, when he invited them to come and to meet his Son, and when they said yes and encountered him for the first time, they were amazed. I pray that you will say yes to Jesus this Christmas, that you'll be looking for him, that you'll have your eyes open to see him, that you'll say yes and that you will encounter Jesus this Christmas in a powerful way, in the way that the shepherds did that first Christmas. There is hope, and his name is Jesus. Let's pray. Father God, I thank you for that first Christmas. I thank you for the message to the shepherds. I thank you, Lord, for what it means to each of us. Father God, I thank you that you met the shepherds where they were. And Lord, you will do the same with us, whatever our situation, whatever our challenges, whatever our history, Lord, you will come and meet with us where we are. And Father, I thank you that you give us the invitation to meet with your Son, Jesus Christ. And Lord, that for those people who have done so, just as the shepherds did, as the wise men did, as many thousands and millions of people have done since, Lord, I thank you that that is a powerful moment, a powerful encounter. And Lord, this Christmas time, with all of its additional challenges and frustrations, Father God, I pray that you would meet with us this Christmas. Lord, I pray we would have our eyes open to see you around us. Lord, I pray that our hearts would be open to receive you. And Father, I pray that we would have a powerful encounter with you this year. That would fire us up, excite us in the same way that it did the shepherds. Lord, that we would have stories that we can tell people about what it was like when we met with you. Father, we thank you for the hope that Jesus brings. We thank you, Lord, for the hope that was first shown that Christmas time. Father, we thank you for the hope that comes through the Easter story. But Father, it all comes through your Son, Jesus, through the sacrifice he made, and through you sending him to die in our place. Lord, remind us of that, I pray. Remind us of the hope that comes only from you and only through Jesus. Lord, would you meet with us this Christmas time? In spite of these difficulties this year, Lord, we may be distant from one another. We may be disconnected from one another. We may feel isolated. But Lord, I thank you that you are God with us. You are Emmanuel. Lord, come and make yourself known to us. Be close to us this Christmas, I pray. And Father God, give us a deep and excited sense of that hope that you bring. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Amen. We're going to close our service by singing again. We have another couple of songs to sing. O Little Town of Bethlehem, and Joy to the World. Let's sing together.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. O morning stars together proclaim a holy the King, and peace to men on earth. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his hand. No image is coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. O holy child of Bethlehem, in and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let us receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him new. And heaven and nature sing.
So as we close our service, I want to leave you with a blessing. This is a blessing that's straight from the pages of the Bible, words straight from Scripture. Let's have a look at this reading from Numbers chapter 6 and verses 24 to 26.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. Amen.
Thank you so much for joining with us for this service today. It's been an absolute joy to have you join us. And from the whole family of Rayleigh Baptist Church, we wish you a very Merry Christmas and a peaceful New Year. God bless you, and we hope to see you all again very soon.
make his face shine upon
you, and be gracious to you.
The Lord turn his face toward you
and give you peace.
Oh, amen. Amen. Amen.
Manna rained down from heaven. This isn't second guessing. We know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and the children, and the children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you
and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and their children,
and their children. May his favor be upon you.
Children, and the children.